Our thanks indeed for staying with us. The program is this morning on ITV, transmitting this Christmas Day morning, the Christmas Day in the year 2018 here. Everyone navigating, like what some call it, this is a political Christmas here. And all the politicians here are crisscrossing and doing the Christmas thing their own way. My name is Iharuata. And this morning we will be looking at it here. Yesterday we saw so many Christmas messages here. The one, our first one that came in quite early, came from President Muhammadu Buhari, the President and Commander-in-Chief of the largest black nation on earth, here, saying that he wished the Christian well, promising that he is committed, assuring that he is committed to electoral reforms here, and he is determined to see that the election 2019 is free, fair, and credible, while appealing to Christians to actually imitate Jesus Christ, the Messiah, and the good traits that he actually believes in, and portray and converse while he walk the path of this earth here. Ike Ekweremadu sent forth his Christmas message as well, urging Nigerians to be peace-loving. The PDP candidate, Atiku Abubakar, sent forth his Christmas message, as well as that of Senate President Bukola Saraki and Speaker Yakubu Dogara. The FCT Minister, Mala Muhammad Musa Bello, is not left out. Lagos State Governor Akin Wumi Ambode sent out his Christmas message here, as well as the Governor of Kaduna State, Malam Nasir Ahmed Rufai. The center point is so much message coming up here. Even the Chairman of AMAC, Abdullahi Kandido, sent forth his own Christmas message. And everywhere you have one big pool of Christmas messages here. The question we'll be asking this morning is, how are these messages impacting? And if possible as well, do these guys actually live up to their Christmas messages that they sent to us, particularly during Christmas and other festive period? My guest on the program this morning is Engineer Olufemi James Ura. He's a politician, a public affairs analyst, and somewhat one who wants to see the best for our society. Are you welcome, Engineer?
Thank you.
Engineer, let's start up quickly here. We got so many Christmas messages here, so many Christmas talk here. Our politicians, when we just oppose them with their messages and what Christmas means, are they learning?
Yes, of course. I mean, our politicians are learning by the day. They mean what they say. You know, Christmas is a time for everyone, time to spend with families and friends. You can imagine you've been working all year, and this is a time where we share with loved ones, so to say. So when individuals come out to pass messages across, of course they mean it, and it comes from their heart solely. Especially this time around, when everything is looking good for us, thanks to the current President Muhammadu Buhari, for what he has done. You know, we feel in a festive mood. There are no queues, you know, everybody's going about their festivities.
Why should I say everyone is talking about no queues? Should there be queues before?
Of course, I mean, you know, previously, you know, I mean, you and I, we know how it happens. I mean, leading on to any festive period, there's a scarcity or maybe a sabotage of petrol. People cannot get by, you know, people want to go to their villages, hometowns, see their families that they haven't seen all year. And you can imagine when there's a shortage, it kind of deters you from having to go home. I mean, you know, transporters, we have to increase their prices. But now, I mean, there's hardly any queues anywhere around the country. I mean, I was in Lagos a few days ago, going around the FCT, everywhere is calm and peaceful. You know, people have been going about their businesses, enjoying themselves. And that's what we are talking about. So, I mean...
Now, are the lessons about Christmas here, the fact that Jesus died, Jesus came in, brought salvation and everything, all what Christmas means, what lesson do you think our politicians can learn from Christmas?
Well, I mean, they say this is the reason for the season. That's Jesus Christ, okay? Now, the lesson politicians, we can take from this is, you know, I mean, life is not a do-or-die affair. You know,
are you sure they like that lesson?
Of course. I mean,
you know, are you sure they like that lesson?
Of course. You know, I mean, we've seen from time to time that you know, even looking at the politics outside of the country, things are done just for the interest of the nation as opposed to individual interest. You know, there's time for dialogue, there's time for, I mean, we have one common goal, which is to make Nigeria great, make Nigeria better. you know, we want people coming in. We are one of the happiest people on earth, and we want to remain so. And we love each other. We have culture. We have all sort of things, tradition that we can embrace. It's all about unity, peace, you know. So, of course, it's a time that politicians are starting to know that we should put the interests of the country as number one, which is why I commend the efforts of Mr. President for everything he has done, you know, putting everybody in check, you know, especially the anti-corruption crusade, which is really going on perfectly, the economy revival, you know, all sort of programs that are making our economy the number one in Africa at the moment, according to the latest Forbes Africa. So the statistics are there. The enabling environments have been provided, and I'm pretty certain that this is the way forward.
Okay, now if we look at this now, one other point here, many persons ask one lesson here, and the one that they all preach and convince to Nigerians, is that of peace here. When we look at peace as being the life of that exemplifies Jesus Christ here, are politicians really committed to peace?
I believe so.
Are they learning from the peace of Jesus?
I believe so, certainly. They say life is a learning curve. Where we may have had some issues in the past, but we're all moving on. We're all moving ahead. And I mean, I can assure you that the coming election, for example, we're coming up to election in 2019. Mr. President, for one, has promised everybody that it's going to be the fairest election, peaceful as at that. You know,
but the article camp is saying that they don't trust that.
Well, that's their opinion. But the government of the day, led by President Muhammadu Buhari, has assured everybody that next year, come February, March, that election is going to be free and fair. The international committee have also suggested that they can see from the programs that are ongoing, that election is going to be free and fair. So, I mean, where would somebody come out and say otherwise? I mean, from what everybody can see right now, the tempo is so cool. People are harmonizing themselves. You know, peace accord has been signed by most stakeholders in the political scene. So, I mean, where would there be anything of such? I mean, it would be silly of us to go back to those days of when you have things going on, crooked means. But I mean, I believe we're now engaging in debates.
You're saying that as Nigerians celebrate 2018 Christmas here, the politicians are learning to be peaceful. Can you vouch for them?
Well, the politicians are peaceful.
Can you vouch for them?
I mean, so far as I know,
you're one of them.
Well,
we've seen them keep talks. I mean, it says that Christmas, they ought to learn how to be peaceful, that Jesus never kept talks.
I mean, this is a season where you have to embrace peace, you have to embrace harmony, you have to embrace unity. That's what the country is all about. So, I mean, this is a season where you have to exhibit those traits of a peace nation. And we have peace-loving people. Of course, we may have been projected as something that we're not, but we Nigerians, we're proud to be Nigerians. Anywhere we go, people tell us that we're happy people, we're friendly, we greet, we're peace-loving people. But, you know, sometimes people just kind of project us as what we're not, and we cannot take that. We are peace-loving people. Our country is rated as one of the happiest on earth. Have you heard of that?
I've heard of that.
We go to places, you're in London, you're in New York, you say hello to people. Naturally, we are friendly people.
Everybody, yes.
We love everybody.
Wake up in the morning and shout.
Yes. Even
at Christmas,
yes.
People carry
Merry
food.
Christmas.
And they give food to the next door neighbor. I don't know who taught us that thing.
Of course. I mean, just, you know, love your neighbor as thyself.
No, at Christmas, just see somebody sharing food to all the neighbors.
Yes. That's service to humanity. And that's what we do naturally. You know, we're brothers keepers. I don't need to know you from Adam. So long as you're my neighbor, you're my friend, I see you on the road, you're a needy person. If I have, I give. I mean, you can only give what you have. But if you do have it, give it, because the more you give, the more God blesses you. So, I mean, and that's the way I think we've been brought up anyway as a nation, and I believe that we still do that. I mean, there's so many people who do things for charity even without knowing it, you know. I mean, you go to some people's places, you have a massive queue of people coming for whatever they need, and they get it, you know. So that's just us. We are peace-loving people.
One lesson also that many are asking, if the politicians are learning, is the issue of a selflessness here. That when they exemplified that with the life of Jesus Christ, he lived a selfless life and wanted to walk and save mankind. But can we say same of our politicians?
Come again.
The issue of the lesson of selflessness, that Jesus Christ was selfless. He just came to this world, lived for humanity. Even you can even say that of some other prophets here. But our politicians, your colleagues, can we say the same?
Yes, of course, most definitely. I mean, example again. I mean, don't permit me when I talk about Mr. President, because for one, he has done something that I would say is selfless, you know. And what has he done? He has created so many programs for Nigerians. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, as you know, Nigeria currently is undergoing a rebuilding process. You know, Nigeria has been bleeding for a long time. So when you're rebuilding a nation, people would have to suffer it. It's just like this room we're in now. If we have to move to this corner while this side is being done, we're going to feel some inconvenience. But in the long run, by the time this room is now overly beautified, we will enjoy it. So Mr. President currently is doing so many work with his team that Nigerians know that eventually, come 2019, come 2023, the result would have been overly exposed. Like, look at the trader money scheme he's doing. That is humanity. That is exemplary of what Jesus did. These are people who don't have the means to do their trade.
But the PDP is not. It's not.
Excuse me. And they're getting these facilities to help their small trade. Look at the money market. That's also going on.
Empower.
So, you know, empower. So there's so many programs that people are benefiting from. And it takes a man like President Muhammadu Buhari to make sure that those programs are well done and people actually manage them properly. Look at everybody's smile on people's faces. You know, that is the promise of the season. You know, everybody is happy, you know, going about their lives, and you know, nobody, you know, it's just, you know, fantastic. So, you know, so that's exemplary. So we use that as a benchmark because we have to give kudos to our president for what he's doing. And, you know, that is why come 2019, I would especially like to see Mr. President come back to carry on with the good works. So, you know, when you hear hashtag come back, that's what we're talking about.
Finally, at Christmas, if you have to speak finally here, what will you be telling the Muslims and the Christians?
Well, you know, Nigeria is a secular nation, especially our constitution recognizes Christian and Islam. Of course, we are one. You know, we are Muslim brothers and sisters. And we should just carry on our activity, enjoy the season. It's the season of love, the season of togetherness. Let's embrace each other and let's just be united. Let's go into the new year peacefully. We have so much to achieve next year. Let's support each other and make things happen for this great nation. You know, I mean, currently we're the number one economy in Africa, and together we can all do this. Now, when you think about the leadership also, of the current leadership, the gap between our generation and the current leadership is wide. And now what Mr. President and this government have done is to pass the bill of Not Too Young to Run, which was what gave people like myself the pathway to contest election this year in the just concluded primaries. And looking at the crowd of the turnout, it was great. So now we're going to a stage whereby things are beginning to happen. So I mean, one thing I would like to say: congratulations, Nigerians. Compliments of the seasons. Whatever you do today, please give the next person closer to you a hug. Love everybody and be peaceful and go about your activity in a civil way. please.
Thank you very much. That has been Engineer Olufemi James Ura. He is a politician as well as a public affairs commentator. He's saying as you go out today, please ensure that you maintain decorum, you do it peacefully, and understand that the next person has the right to also be happy, and also please then to drive carefully. Thank you very much for coming, Engineer.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, on that note, we end this morning on ITV segment for today, being Christmas Day, 25th of December 2018. Many of you are just going to go out there. Hope the stews are out. You know, the stews that the aroma will kill the next door neighbor here. Very nice one. Okay, that's how we're going to go on the program. On behalf of the crew and production team here, I say goodbye. Have a lovely, successful day and a wonderful Christmas.